you have to understand reading the newspaper for the UPSC and reading as a common citizen is different. So you have to follow certain methodology. And how that methodology? Don't treat it is a textbook. So many people, what they do, they make this newspaper a book itself. They start covering the newspaper in very detail, religiously. That is not required because they will not ask. And by qualification, I am a graduate in commerce and I am a chartered accountant. I am the faculty and also one of the director at Didami.com. I have appeared 3 times in the IAS interview. I have 7 years of teaching experience and have taught at offline institutes in Delhi as well as online classes. I am the expert in GS prelims cum mains. Now, about Didami IAS. So Didami IAS is a very fastly growing platform which is committed to crown you with the success, and your success is at the top of our mind. So the team Didami IAS, the entire team, is committed for your success. Now, something about the Didami. So we have impacted over 30,000 students. We have 50 plus toppers and we have 15 plus active courses, and we are known for quality and personal attention. So we are having 2 USPs. Now, these are the toppers of 2018 batch and these are the toppers of 2019 batch. This session is part of the Margdarshan free webinar series. So Margdarshan free webinar series, in this series we have come up with these sessions. So on 30th September we had the session about how to master the GS economy. Today we are having the current affairs session. On 6th of October we will be having the GS mains booster session, how to master the mains for the civil services. Then on 8th of October we will discuss about answer writing. On 12th of October, essay writing. On 15th of October, international relations. On 19th of October, NCERT. 25th of October, about prelims MCQ solving. So this series you must attend, and I promise in every session you will get lot of value. So are you excited? Are you coming in every session? And we will email you the link. Now, what are the issues faced by the students about the current affairs? So why don't you say, why don't you just write in a line, what problems do you face, and then we can see. So I would invite, please type in the chat box, next 30 seconds please type your problems. Okay Parth, what to read? Okay Ashutosh, which sources to go for the current affairs? Very good question. Keep typing everyone please, because this session is for you only. I wanted to make it successful for you people, right? Kavin Bharti, you are a fresher and you don't know much about it. Okay Shweta, I am confused on which topics we have to concentrate. Okay I got it. Okay keep typing, and meanwhile let me share. From my experience of over 7 years, I have come to know the problems faced by the students. So which all sources to follow? There are so many sources. Which newspaper? 1, 2 or more? How to read magazines? How to prepare the current affairs overall? How much duration of current affairs should be covered? How much time should be devoted on a daily basis? How to make notes? Should we make the notes on a daily basis? Sir, what about MCQ practice? Should we practice the MCQ of current affairs? And how about answer writing? So I am going to address all of them, right? So in this session, I will tell about the current affairs, the weightage, syllabus and the previous year questions. I will discuss about the different sources, newspaper, which pages and what not to read. Then how to prepare the notes, Yojana Kurukshetra, monthly compilations, India yearbook, PIB, Rajyasabha TV, and then we have AIR News, then Niti Aayog. So lot many sources are there. Apart from that, we have economic survey and so on. I am going to discuss each and every area, and then in the last we will discuss how Didomi IAS can support you. So starting with the importance of the current affairs. In the prelims examination, the importance is minimum 40%. Even static portion, which is coming, that has a complete linkage with the current affairs only. So even if there is a static concept, a static question coming in the examination, they are asking because that concept has been in news in the recent past. In the mains examination, the weightage is approximately 50%. And if you are having an optional which has an important current affairs role, for example political science, sociology, then this role becomes approximately 70%. Interview, entire interview is based upon the current affair only. Many a time 100% interview is based upon the current affair. So can you see the importance? Now in this session we are going to focus on what should be the daily strategy, how to cover the newspaper, which sources to follow and how to focus upon every source. And this session is going to be focused on the prelims. This session is focused on the prelims because in the prelims itself we have lot to cover, and then for the mains we will be having a separate session. In the mains we will be having a separate session. So this session for the mains is scheduled on 6th of October. So schedule yourself 6th of October. The time will be 8 p.m. right? So 8 p.m. 6th of October, we will discuss about how to prepare the current affairs for the mains. Now starting with, first of all, current affairs is not equal to newspaper, right? Every Indian is reading newspaper, does not mean that they are preparing for the current affair. You have to differentiate between the issues and the topics and the news. So in the IAS examination, they are asking about the issues and the topics, not about the news. So for example, recently there has been the issue about gang rape in Hathras. So here it is a news. So in UPSC, they will not ask about the news. They can ask about the the growing crimes against women, the status of women in India. So we have to prepare from that perspective. We have to know about the various government schemes which are available for the women. What are the recent budget initiatives, recent economic survey observations? Every source, you have to understand that every source of the current affair has something unique to offer. I will tell how we can utilize each and every source. Then in current affairs, you have to first understand the UPSC requirement, right? Because we are preparing for the IAS examination. It is not a random study. So we have to understand the UPSC requirement first. So all these sources we have: Hindu, Express, Economic Survey, Yojana, Kurukshetra, India Yearbook and Budget. Now let us start one by one. First of all, you have to limit your sources. You have to decide the boundaries, and that is not an easy task. So how to do that? So for deciding the boundaries, you should first read the UPSC syllabus, both prelims and mains, because ultimate purpose is to crack the IAS examination. So for the prelims examination, we have this syllabus, but this syllabus is not enough to tell us what is the coverage of current affair. So for detailed coverage, we should understand the trend from the previous year question. So we should analyze the previous year question. We should have the previous year question bank, and based upon that previous year question, we will see which topic to cover and which not to cover. And most importantly, we should analyze, we should always by heart this main syllabus, right? So take a printout of the main syllabus, and this syllabus should be on your study table. So you can see here, this history part is not that much important, but you see role of women, like this is about the GS1 mains. So in GS1 means role of women, effect of globalization, empowerment, communalism, regionalism, secularism. So you can understand that when Delhi riot happened, we had to link that with the communalism. Similarly, in the geography, the distribution of key natural resources. When there was corona, like corona is at its peak, which country is very good in the pharma resources, like that. And geophysical phenomena, earthquake, tsunami, volcano, and there are lot many other problems going on. Then in the GS paper 2, everything, like the good thing with the GS main syllabus is that they have given each and every topic in detail. So nothing like that. What I will suggest that you should make a separate A4 sheet for each and every word which has been mentioned, each and every topic which has been mentioned in this syllabus. So you can see in the paper 2, we have a constitution, we have the Representation of People Act, which is about elections. We have NGO, self-help group, right? So go through the syllabus. I'm not going into detail. Similarly, GS3 also you can go. Similarly, GS4 also you can go. So this syllabus will give you the complete idea about what to read, what not to read. And if you are a complete beginner, if this is your first month, then it will take some time. Have some patience. After some time, you will understand very, very easily. Okay. Now, previous year questions will give you a lot of idea. So for example, this prelims paper, if you follow the previous year paper, you will get to know that they have asked about global climate change. They have talked about National Investment Infrastructure Fund, Mediterranean and Sea. They have talked about Global Infrastructure Facility. So if you go through the previous year question again and again, at some point of time, you will get that, okay, these topics are important. Similarly, also go through the previous year mains paper, right? Mains paper you must also go through, right? So this is the mains paper. Here you can see gender budgeting, employment, Jan Dhan Yojana, smart cities, FDI, then inclusive growth. So you get an idea which topics are coming in the newspaper. Now how many newspapers to follow? Primarily in UPSC we have two newspapers. One is Hindu, second is Indian Express. So you must follow any one paper. Both paper are good. As per your convenience, as per your temperament, follow both paper. Follow one paper out of both. If you are not sure which paper to follow, what you can do, you start reading one newspaper, follow it for 15 days, then change the newspaper, use that for next 15 days, and after that, decide which newspaper is better for you. But once you decide, then don't change it again and again. Throughout your preparation, follow that newspaper. Yeah, you can follow second newspaper for some special editorial or for some special section, but not completely. So if you are following the Hindu newspaper, then Indian Express, you can follow explained section. If you are following the Indian Express, then in Hindu, you can follow the Friday debate and the op-ed page, right? So you have to follow the very selected portion from the second newspaper. And don't buy two newspapers. Buy one newspaper. For second newspaper, you can refer to some website or you can refer to some online UPSC preparation website. Don't follow Economic Times, Business Standard, Business Line. Even if your economy is very, very weak, never ever follow that. Okay? Never ever follow that because that is not required. What are the advantages? So many people say, sir, should we really follow the newspaper? Isn't it enough that we follow the daily current affair from website or monthly compilation or yearly compilation? So I will say you should devote some time for the newspaper. If you are a beginner, you should devote 1 hour to 1.5 hour. If you have prepared for a sufficient time, maybe like 2 months, 5 months, 6 months, then give maximum 40 minutes to 1 hour, not more than that, but must go through the newspaper. There is no choice, because what are the advantages? Let me tell you, it maintains continuity in your preparation. And never think that reading newspaper is the wastage of time. If you compare yourself and your friend who is not reading the newspaper, you will find lot of difference in your knowledge and in your answers in the MCQs. this continuity. For example, recently Prime Minister Modi, he talked about UNSC reform. So if that news is there, 3-4 days it is coming again and again, different experts are giving their views, the newspaper is giving the facts, you actually become comfortable with that topic. So this continuity helps a lot. It makes the preparation very easy. It helps improving the vocabulary. There are very unique words which are used in very in different subjects. So those subjects, those vocabulary become your normal way of life. So it don't become a difficulty to write the answers or to write the essays. Then it broadens your perspective, because in every newspaper they are talking about the historical dimension, geographical dimension, economic, social, political. So they are giving comprehensive analysis that helps you think and build your opinion based upon your own temperament and based upon the facts. It gives the comprehensive coverage, especially the editorial part is very important, because editorial is written by the highly expert people, and their experience, you can understand how do they write. This source is very, very authentic, right? Normally they always quote the source of the news. So never miss the newspaper. And most importantly, Hindu, it is supposed to be the unbiased as far as the reporting of news is concerned, and ultimately it helps in the answer writing. Now, how much time we should focus? So as I said, maximum 1 hour. And should it be the morning time, evening time? I will say use your unproductive or lazy time. If you are not willing to read and you have to read, follow the newspaper, because then you will find something new. It will not become boring. Your mind will not be resisting to this. So use your unproductive time. Don't use your productive time, because in the productive time you should follow the difficult subject. Then newspaper reading, you have to understand, reading the newspaper for the UPSC and reading as a common citizen is different. So you have to follow certain methodology. And how that methodology? Don't treat it is a textbook. So many people, what they do, they make this newspaper a book itself. They start covering the newspaper in very detail, religiously. That is not required, because they will not ask on 2nd of October, second page, this news was there, please explain that news. They are not going to ask that. You have to use this as a reference material for your understanding, for clarity of issues. You don't have to follow it as a reference, follow as a textbook. So don't cover each and every news, don't cover each and every page. And most importantly, understand the difference between the news and the issue. As I already told you, news means, for example, Hathras gang rape, okay, and issue means the crimes against women, the schemes of the government with respect to women, like that. So you have to understand, always try to link the news with the syllabus where this issue can be asked. For example, if there is a violence at the border, so that border violence will not be discussed, rather what are the issues, what is the historical angle behind that border issue, what problems are there between the between India and Pakistan, like that. So you have to focus on the issue, not on the news. Then how to start? Now most importantly, how to start the newspaper. So if you start the newspaper and if you start reading the every page, then it will take a lot of time. So best way is you follow some website and start with the daily news prescription of that. For example, at Diadem IAS, we are giving this prescription on a daily basis. So by 11 a.m. we upload this analysis, we upload this list of article. You read only these articles, right? And rest of the article you should cut out, or just read the headline, nothing else. After you have covered the list of news which are to be covered, then how to ensure that you do not cover the unwanted news? So cut it out, don't let it be there, just cut it out. And start with reading the first paragraph of the selected news, right? Because in the first paragraph they are given the context and mostly what, why, how, where, who, all of these things are addressed in the first paragraph itself. And you can decide, should I cover it again, should I complete this news or should I leave it. So first paragraph you should cover and then you decide whether to cover fully or not. Now, which are the important pages in the Hindu newspaper? Front is very, very important, always very, very important. Next is the Nation News. Nation page is very important. In the Nation page, again, focus on the issues, not on the news. Editorial is very, very important. World section, business, then sports. In the sports, not much important, only few things are important. Now, this is the front page of today's newspaper, 2nd of October. And this is very important. At the same time, not every news is important. You have to differentiate. For example, this is not important. This side is really important. Now, this is important. GST is important. So, you should follow this GST. You should research more about it. You should, you know, try your, you know, concept, whether you are good at it or not, and so on. So, even in front page, you have to decide. And for that, the best thing is daily news prescription. Through that, you will be able to understand which what to read, what not to read. Editorial page is the most important page. But let me tell you again, not every editorial is important. Many a time, there are articles or editorials which are completely useless. So again, for that, we have to follow the daily news prescription. And after certain time, after couple of months or after 6 months, you will be comfortable because you know what to read, what not to read. So in editorial page, you have many articles. Then this op-ed page is very important, especially these debates. Should online gambling be regulated in India or not? So here you will find the experts are giving their views, and these views are very, very broad and very, very expert. So never miss this portion, right? No summary, no synopsis, no website can replace this. Okay, so these type of thing you should cover quickly, right? Now, how to read? First read the headline, then the first paragraph, then try to link with the syllabus. For example, this online gambling was there, so this is part of the GS paper 2 mains, the regulations in India. Okay, once you decide that, then you will be able to decide that how much depth we should follow. Is it part of the syllabus or not, right? Then what not to read? Don't read political news, BJP, Congress, Rahul Gandhi, all that. Unless they are in the power. If they are in power, they are introducing the government scheme, then only you should follow, otherwise not. Then awards, deaths, those are not important for the UPSC. Sports, IPL, all those things are not important unless it is a Commonwealth and there is some special news. Side columns, mostly they are not important. States part, northeast, south, all these things are really important. Hardly there is a news. City pages also, they are not very good, but many a time you find some models, some good examples there. So you can see we have cut down this side news, mostly they are unimportant. Then you can see this city pages less important, you can cut it down, right? Really there is some good thing you can just see. And you can see, for example, this Kejriwal louts IARI for developing low cost technology to manage stubble. So this kind of models can be there, this kind of example you can take, otherwise really there is something important. So this northeast page, this is also not that much important. I mean, I'm not saying that never ever you will find a news, but really you will find the news. Okay, now Indian Express front page, city that is also again not important unless there is some important interview. The government and politics, it is only if there is a news about policy, then you should follow. Express Network, not important. Explained is very, very important, you must follow. Editorial and ideal page, it is very, very important. Then world section, you should read about if there is a discussion about some issue, dispute or some foreign policy. Economy, again, I mean, you have to follow as per the requirement of the syllabus and follow the syllabus, follow the previous year question. There is no shortcut. After a certain time, you will become comfortable slowly. Now, how to prepare the notes? So for that, you must have two things in your study table. One is the L-shaped folder. These transparent folder you must have. Make one folder for one subject. One for economy, one for polity, one for science and technology, one for international relations, government scheme, like that. Then have loose A4 sheet with you, right? Don't make a traditional register, because these A4 sheet, they can be updated, they can be rearranged. Suppose you want to use this A4 sheet after 2 years, so after 2 years you can eliminate those which are outdated, because current affairs are changing very fast, the issues are changing very fast. So after some time you can eliminate outdated news from these A4 sheets. Okay, so use these two material. Now how to make the notes, how to prepare the notes. First of all, divide this L-shaped folder into various areas of the syllabus, the prelim syllabus and the main syllabus, right? So you can follow this list of topic which I have given over here. So let me quickly discuss: polity, social schemes, infrastructure, science and technology. Divide that into national, international, environment, biodiversity, economy, sports. Then you can discuss IR part, defense, in the defense, missile, space, IT, personality, geography, in the geography, the location, rivers, earthquake, then national summits, international summits, all that. So if you make separate page for every important news, then you will be better able to revise and organize in the time of examination. Okay, now the question is, sir, is it important to make the notes? So my answer is, it is not important, and it all depends upon your time availability. If you are a working professional or you are a college student, you don't have a time, then no need to make the notes. If you are preparing full time, you have already covered the static syllabus, then you can make the notes. You can devote maximum 1.5 hour to 2 hour in the entire process, including the reading of newspaper, finding the news and making the notes, not more than that. Okay, now so it all depends, right? Now how to make the notes, how to prepare the notes, what should be the strategy? So for that, first of all, find the relevant news. For example, in today's newspaper, this is the relevant news from the front page. Now from this news, just see the headline and the image. So in the image itself, you will find the important trend. Okay, GST collections have been rising year on year. So what is the meaning of year on year? If you don't know, go to the Google and search it. Okay, then GST, what do you know about GST? What is GST? What are the important features? If you don't know, then you should follow your study material from wheresoever you are following your booklet, and you should take from there. Then just read the first paragraph. In the first paragraph itself, you will come to know whether we have to cover this complete news or not, and then start underlining the important words here. And after you have started doing that, then you will realize that out of the total news, there are hardly 2-3 points which I need to note in my news notes, in the current affairs notes. And after that, what you do, you note down the notes from these keywords and also the background. Okay, so on the right hand side the news, and on the left hand side the background, like that. So you can do like that. Okay, and keep doing this work in the loose sheet, not in the proper register, right? So that you can discard outdated notes. Okay, so read, underline notes in the A4 sheet, try to underline the keywords and write those, focus on the data and trends, background you should do as much as possible. Okay, now mind map you should make if possible, if the issue is very big, and make the notes of issue, not the notes of news. So in this case, you should make a separate page for the GST, and in that page only you should keep updating the news whenever there is a news about GST. Okay, don't try to make the page as per the date. Okay, these are the news of 2nd October, these are the news of 3rd October. No, don't do that. Rather, make the notes as per the topic name. So the A4 sheet should belong to a topic, not to the date of the news. Okay, now should we do it online or offline? Again, that is a very subjective thing, depends upon person to person. Suppose I feel that offline is good for me, I feel comfortable in that, So I can do offline. If you feel that you are comfortable in online, then you can do that also, right? So that is a personal choice, nothing good, nothing bad. But offline notes, when you are making, you should have some margin, and it is better to comprehend as compared to the online notes, because from the childhood itself, we have been studying out the offline notes. Online notes you can make on various apps, for example Quips, Evernote. They are easy to update, they are easy to organize. You just click and type the topic and you will find the notes. So both have their pros and cons. There is no hard and fast rule. It does not make much of the difference in your preparation. Okay, so your marks will not vary much because of online or offline. It is your sincerity, relevance and accurate focus which will decide the result, not the offline or online. Now this is very important source, that is the Press Information Bureau. This is the government website and this gives lot of information. Government initiative, government schemes, all of that is given in this website. So most of the time you will find 80% of the newspaper, 80% of the items of the PIB, they are covered in the newspaper. There's 20%. For that you can follow some daily PIB analysis or monthly PIB analysis, and that is done. And this PIB, it can act as a revision tool. But I will not suggest that you go on the website and search each and every news on the PIB. That is not suggested, because already if you are following Hindu newspaper, many 80% of the things are covered from the PIB itself. Yeah, it is good important government policy, but for that you can follow some synopsis. Now do you want to save the time in doing all this? So we have discussed daily news prescription, we have discussed finding the important news, reading those, then searching background, making notes, following the PIB, all that. So that is a very big task, not an easy task. If you want to save time, then you can follow some website and follow that religiously. Okay, follow that religiously. So for example, at our Didomi IAS, we are providing daily current affairs analysis, and we are covering each and every source. We are covering the Hindu, PIB, Indian Express, and we are dividing them into scheme policies and subject name, science and technology, geography, economy, and we are focusing completely on the topics which are important for the UPSC, and we are doing the complete background analysis, and we are covering the newspaper, Indian Express and any other source if we found it better. And this is being done on a daily basis, and we are providing it free of cost on Telegram, and we will upload on the website also. Well researched background, there is a team which is working for that. No need to choose which news to read and which not to read. And we are covering two newspaper PIB, and it is a completely micro focused based, right? So if you register with us, then we will email you on a regular basis. But keep in mind, this should not replace your newspaper. Follow your 30 minute schedule for the newspaper. You must flip the newspaper. Don't skip the newspaper. Okay, don't skip the newspaper. You must flip the newspaper on a daily basis, at least average 30 minutes. Even if you have covered everything from our initiative, still, because newspaper will give you a kind of understanding which cannot be replaced unless you are working professional. If you are working professional or you have scarcity of time, then don't do that. Don't need to follow the newspaper. Then you can rely on the daily current affairs synopsis, right? So you can see these various topics which we have covered in detail, objectives, component, everything, like topic we are covering in sufficient detail, right? So for example, hydrogen and this CNG, this topic we have covered, the context, the analysis, comparison between the various type of gases, CNG, PNG, etc. So we are covering everything in detail. You can follow this as per your choice. Now the very important aspect, monthly current compilation. Sir, you have told us about daily current affairs, you have told about newspaper, you have told about news notes making. Sir, still should we follow the monthly current compilation? So friends, there is a very important aspect of the current affairs, that we should revise them again and again, again and again. Revision, multiple revision is very, very important. So this monthly current compilation should not be used as an extra source, and you should not search for the extra news here. Rather, you should consider that, okay, this is the compilation subject wise, and I can just flip and I can follow the complete compilation, and I can complete the complete month news at one go, right? So it will become a source of revision for you rather than additional source of information. So don't try to search for that extra information. If you find something, it is good. If you don't find, then not a problem. If you are following daily current affairs, if you are devoting 1 hour to 1.5 hour, then monthly current affair compilation will be very, very comfortable for you. You feel happy, your confidence will increase. And if you are weak in some area, you will get more information about that area and you will feel more comfortable in that area. Okay, so treat this as a source of revision rather than source of extra information. Now, how to cover that? First of all, try to look for the missing part and try to look for the difficult part. Okay, so during the daily newspaper, you must be having some discomfort, maybe with economy or maybe with geography, like that. So through these current affairs, monthly compilation, you will find all the complete month economy at single place, complete month science and tech at single place, complete month geography at single place. So you can actually follow the complete month and you can see that what is the interlinkage between different news, right? And before you move ahead, before you start reading the current compilation, first read the index and you will actually, you know, try to recall from the index itself that how much you know about each and every topic. So if you know 50% or more, then feel happy. If you know 50% or less of that topic, then you should mark that so that next time you can revise it again and again. Okay, so this index should be used as a tool, not just to find the page number. Okay, then follow only one magazine. If you are following Didomi, follow that. If you are following some other, follow that. Don't try to change it again and again. Okay, follow one only. So we are also providing it on a monthly basis, right? Now you should decide a cutoff date. Means, for example, for September month, you should decide that, okay, by 10th of October, I will cover this magazine at any cost. Don't try to make backlog. Sir, abhi toh mujhe last 4 months ki cover nahi hui hai. Don't do that, okay? Try to have a cutoff date at the beginning of every month. By 10th of every next month, try to complete last month compilation at any cost. Try to have these small target, and I'm telling you, you will become comfortable in the current affairs. Current affairs will become a comfortable zone for you rather than a challenge. So this is the Didomi IAS monthly compilation. You can see we have given the topic list. This is the topic list from the Press Information Bureau, like that. So just start seeing Consumer Protection Bill and what are the important provisions. Start thinking what are the important provisions. Try to recall. Then take second topic, try to recall. Take third topic, try to recall. If you try to recall, if you give pressure to your mind, there will be a vacuum. Vacuum means your mind will be hungry to get more of facts and knowledge about this topic. And you will feel that, okay, let me study this right now because I am really feeling uncomfortable. So, aapko padhne mein man karega uska. Aapko jo gaps honge, wo aap fill up kar paoge. Jo aapne cheez bhul gaye, jo aapne retain nahi kar paaye, aap usko फटाफट से रिटेन कर सकते हो. सो दिस इज अ वेरी गुड अप्रोच. इफ यू फॉलो द इंडेक्स ऑफ द मंथली कंपाइलेशन, नथिंग लाइक दैट. ओके, नथिंग लाइक दैट. नाउ, सो नाउ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट सर, शुड आई प्रैक्टिस एमसीक्यू ऑफ द करंट अफेयर? सो यू शुड प्रैक्टिस द एमसीक्यू, बट दे कैन बी टू अप्रोच. वन अप्रोच इज द डेली एमसीक्यू एंड अनदर अप्रोच इज द मंथली एमसीक्यू. सो आई विल सजेस्ट you go for the monthly MCQ, not daily MCQ. Why? Because monthly MCQ, they are prepared after analyzing the complete month MCQ, complete month news. In the daily MCQ, there can be incomplete data, because in a particular day in the newspaper, that news may not be complete in itself. For example, if there is a news about some new government in a scheme. So maybe on the first day, government will not give complete information. So MCQ, which is prepared based upon that information, will not be the best MCQ. But if government gives next information after 1 week, third information after 1 month, so the MCQ which is prepared at the end of the month from that scheme will be the best MCQ. Okay, so don't try to waste your time on the daily MCQ. I will suggest follow the monthly MCQ. So at the end of every month, once you finish the monthly compilation, then follow the MCQ. Okay, then practice the MCQ in time bound manner. Take 2 hours and then solve the MCQ. After solving that, then see what are the uncomfortable area. Mark those areas so that in the next revision you can revise those areas first. Are you getting my friends? Are you enjoying the session? Is it worth coming here? Please say yes or no. And don't worry, I will give you the Telegram link. Okay, don't worry about that. So just give me a few seconds. I'm just sharing the Telegram channel link because many people are demanding that. Okay, Sashwati, I got it. Bhumika, Tamajit. Okay, great. So happy. Mona Lisa, Kavin Bharti, Shakti Meena. Very good. Wonderful. Okay, so coming back. So we have covered daily news prescription. We have covered daily news analysis. We have covered PIB. We have covered monthly compilation. We have covered the MCQ. If you do this kind of work, you don't need to follow any yearly compilation, right? And don't worry about the perfectness in the current affairs. That will come slowly. Okay, current affairs will always be a challenging area. Don't try to think that I will become super comfortable in current affairs. That will never happen because hundreds of developments are happening on a daily basis. You cannot control that. Okay, but what you can do, if you follow regular, if you become regular, then you will know what to do, what not to do. Okay, so MCQ cover at the end of the month, only after completing the monthly compilation, and as much as possible it should be from the same source from where you have taken the magazine, and you should practice minimum 100 questions from every month. Okay, so that is the best approach you should follow. Now there is a question, sir, there are so many online websites. Some website is providing analysis of PIB, some website is providing the analysis of Da Hindu, some is providing the analysis of Yojana, Kurukshetra, AIR News, Rajya Sabha TV, so on and so forth. There is an unending list, lot of confusion. I will suggest follow one website only. If you are following Diadem IAS, follow this, don't follow other website. If you are following other website, follow that. I mean, trust wherever you are following anything, right? Don't try to follow multiple websites because these sources are for your comfort, not to give you extra information. I mean, if you follow two websites, you will find that 90% of the things are common everywhere. So as per your temperament, as per your comfort, follow whichever website you want to follow. Now Yojana monthly magazine, how should we cover that? So for Yojana monthly, first of all, how much duration? So duration of only last 1 year. So for 2021 examination, you should follow the June 20 onwards only. So question arises, sir, should I buy the original Yojana or should I follow the Yojana notes prepared by some online website? My suggestion is follow the original Yojana and don't give more than 4 to 5 hours. Okay, how to cover the Yojana, let me tell you. So in the Yojana, there is a chief editor's desk. This is the first page. This page is the best page of the entire Yojana. What you should do, you should take the last 2 years chief editor desk and try to read these, and via Diademy we will provide it, we will upload it in the free download section very soon. So on our website there is a section free resources. In the free resources there is free download. There we will upload last 24 month chief editor desk compilation. Why you need to follow this? Because Here it is the complete summary of that particular topic. For example, this Yojana is about Resurgent India. So everything about Resurgent India, they are using very good terminology, from enabler, from provider to enabler. They are providing very good facts. They are providing the historical analysis. They are providing the way forward. They are providing the government scheme name. I mean, this is the best page. You will understand how to write the essay from this, how to write the introduction, how to write the conclusion, how to insert the facts, how to write the write any topic in the minimum number of words, and you will actually able to you will actually be able to understand how experts write, right? So last 24 month, this first page you must have. So we will upload in our website and you can cover from there. Apart from that, you should cover is the index. In the index, you should pick up the selected articles, not every article. Yojana Monthly is not meant for UPSC preparation only. This is meant for the research and development, R&D. Okay, so in every Yojana, there will be maximum 3 to 4 articles which you need to follow. So just follow those articles, underline the keywords, make your notes, and discard the Yojana. Don't follow anything else from the those articles. Apart from the articles, there are some government schemes pages. So for example, there is a Yojana on the Atmanirbharta Bharat Abhiyan. So there they have given the amendments in the Essential Commodities Act. So these topics which are given in the Yojana, they are very important. Even if they not be, they will not be providing the extra information about this particular scheme, but from this you can identify that this happens to be the most important scheme, and the chances of coming of this scheme in the examination are very, very high. So note down the name of this government scheme and try to cover such government scheme in a very systematic manner. And at Didami, we are going to bring the list of all the government scheme which have been covered in the last 1 year, so that you can prepare those schemes in a systematic manner in the next, for the next examination. Okay, now apart from this, there are some case studies, there are some role models or some important practices which are being adopted by various countries or various cities or various state government. They also come in the Yojana, so just note down them if there is some. Okay, if it is not there, then ignore that, but try to have maximum 5 to 6 hours for one Yojana. Don't devote more than that. So once it comes, within 1 week complete this. Okay, so the Yojana of October month you must complete by 10th of October. Okay, don't drag this, don't try to invest more time. So this is a challenge for you. Are you taking on this challenge? October Yojana you will complete by 10th of October. How many of you are taking this challenge? So do you remember the last challenge which I gave in the last webinar? Anyone who remembers the last challenge which I gave in the last webinar? Last webinar was on the economy. I gave the challenge. The challenge was to cover the first chapter of the 11th NCERT, Indian Economic Development. Before that, I also gave one challenge, that is cover 3 chapters of the Indian Constitution at Work. Okay, so today I am giving the challenge, cover the Yojana magazine by 10th of October and cover in this systematic manner. Second challenge I am giving, try to follow my guideline for the next 1 week. Okay, daily news prescription, first paragraph of the important news, daily current synopsis at the end of the day, and just complete this. Next 1 week, follow the guideline which I told by me. If you follow any guideline on a daily basis, it becomes a habit. Okay, and habit cannot be broken easily. If it becomes a habit, then you don't have to spend your time, money and energy to look for more productive way. Okay, so are you ready? Are you ready for this challenge? How many of you are taking this challenge, following the guidelines given by me for the next 1 week? And let me tell you, this may not be the best strategy which I am sharing with you. I am having the experience of qualifying the prelims examination 5 times and mains examination 3 times, and I have used this kind of strategy and it happened to be successful in my case. So I am telling you, this is one of the good strategy, may not be the only strategy. There can be other strategies also. Okay. Now coming to the next. So we have seen in the Yojana, chief editor desk, certain articles, government schemes, and the case studies. Now similarly in the Kurukshetra also, it is exactly same. In the Kurukshetra also, editorial is must. Okay. And after editorial, you should select some important editorial, important article from the index itself. For example, in this Kurukshetra of June 2020, we have water management, smart agriculture. These two very, very important. Then solution to groundwater crisis. So, and then irrigation projects. Okay. So 3-4 article you will find are very, very important. So government policies, if they are given about the agriculture sector, you must cover those government schemes, right? So for example, in this Kurukshetra, they have covered the Atmanirbharta package and the various component. Again, you already might be having the information about this scheme, but once this scheme comes in the Yojana magazine or Kurukshetra magazine, then it becomes important for the examination. Okay. Now, so editorial, important area, government policies, and it is important for prelims and both. Now, India yearbook. This will come once in a year, probably in the month of January to March. So this India yearbook, you don't need to follow page by page. For this, first of all, you have to understand that this is important only for the government scheme. So they have given the list of chapters, and you must underline the important chapter name and follow only those chapters. Not suggested to read each and every chapter, each and every word. Okay, not to cover completely. Only selected chapters you must cover. So for example, these are the chapters which are important for the economy, and there are certain chapters which are important for the polity. So for every area there are certain chapters which are important, and at Didami we will be uploading the list of important chapters in the month of February 2021. So you can take the list of important chapter from there, and again after getting that list, don't try to read each and every word, rather only the government scheme and underlining of that. Okay. So this is how you have to cover the India yearbook. Now, Rajya Sabha TV. So nowadays there is a very high level of confusion. Should we follow the Rajya Sabha TV? The answer is no. Answer is no. But yes, we can take some advantage, because as I said in the starting itself, every source has some unique thing. So what you can do? You can make a list of topic which appeared in the big picture. Big picture is a serial which comes on the Rajya Sabha TV, and you should list down the name of topic on which this big picture came in the last 6 months, and those topic you should prepare yourself, or if you are already prepared, then it is very good. If you have not prepared some topic, prepare that topic, because again this is the government channel, so the chances of coming of this type of topic in the news in the exam becomes high. And at Didami IAS, we will be providing the list, this list of last 6 month topic on the free download section within a week. Okay, so you can go to a website. In the website you will find free resources. In the free resources you will find free download, and from there you can download the list of last 6 month important topic which are there. Okay. Now this Rajya Sabha TV you can follow at the time of interview. After you have completed your mains examination, then you can watch this on a daily basis, because it will give you an idea how to answer challenging question, how to answer debatable issues, because retired bureaucrats, ministers, experts, academicians, lecturers, they come and they explain their point of view on various issues in this topic. Now AIR News, All India News, in this again the same thing, there is a daily news analysis portion. In the daily news analysis portion, you just find the list of topic which appeared there. No need to listen on a daily basis, unless this is your fourth, fifth attempt and you are fed up of completing so many books again and again. So you have plenty of time, then you can follow this. Otherwise, not required. Okay, no need to follow on a daily basis. Now economic survey. Economic survey also comes once in a year. So economic survey will come, next economic survey will come in the month of February 21. So economic survey, it has two volume. Volume 1 is important for the mains examination. Again, you should not read word by word. Try to interlink with the syllabus. and make your notes. Volume 2 is important for the prelims examination. And in this also only chapter number 1 to 5 are important, not rest. So if you follow the chapter number 1 to 5 and do the MCQ practice based upon that, it is more than sufficient. Okay. And only 2 years economic survey are sufficient, not more than that. Okay. Don't try to cover the economic survey of multiple year. At Didomi IAS, in the free resource section, free download, we have given the notes of volume 1, volume 2 of last year and the MCQ also, and the notes of the budget also. So you can download and you can understand what kind of notes should be made. I will suggest for economic survey, don't try to read the complete booklet, original booklet. If you have a lot of time, then you can do that. Otherwise, you can just follow any notes and that is more than sufficient. Now, every budget, every year budget also comes. In the budget, what should you follow? Important trends. For example, the fiscal deficit. What is the trend of fiscal deficit in last 5 years? So that kind of trend. What is the trend of income tax? Is it increasing in the last 5 years or it is decreasing? Then every budget has some new government scheme. Try to find more about those government scheme. Although everything is coming in the newspaper about the budget, but still, if you follow the budget synopsis, then you get lot many data also. You can use that data in the mains answer writing. Now, how much duration should be there about the current affairs? So if you are appearing for 2021, then you should start from June 2020. Don't follow more news. Okay. June 2020 onwards, it is more than sufficient. And then also keep in mind that the period between December to April of December 22 April 21 will be the most important. Most of the MCQ will be coming from this area. Okay. Similarly, if you are appearing for 2022, you can start reading the newspaper from 2021. As of now, you can just focus upon the basic syllabus, NCERT standard books. No need to follow the current affair as of now. Okay. How about answer writing on the mains issues based upon the current affairs? So for the answer writing, we will have a separate session. We will have a separate session about how to prepare for the GS mains current affairs, because mains current affair is a very different thing. Yeah, the complete process which I discussed today will be completely useful for the mains also. You have to do this process on a daily basis, follow this process for the mains also. But how to prepare the notes, what should be the approach for reading the issue, how to ensure that you get everything from the newspaper for the mains, I will discuss on 6th of October. 6th of October is meant for GS mains. I will discuss everything about GS mains. Okay. So mark the date 6th October, 8 p.m. 6th October, 8 p.m. I will discuss everything about that. Okay. Now your queries. So please list down your queries, whatsoever queries you have. I will answer those. And meanwhile, let me tell you about our current affairs booster program, which is starting 10th of October. And whatever I discussed in this session today, we are going to provide you every resource, every support in for that. Okay. So we will be having live interactive sessions. 2 lectures will be taken on the weekend. So if you are a college student or you are a working professional, no need to worry. You will be also getting the recording, which you can see unlimited number of time. 100 MCQ based monthly test will also be provided. And you will have to solve them. Your ranking will be given at the end of the month. Okay. Daily news prescription will be given. Daily current synopsis will be emailed to you on a daily basis. Monthly compilation will be given. And there will be an Excel sheet which we will maintain for every student. You have to mark that you have completed or not. And after that, like on 11th of every month, we will be having the test session, oral test, where faculty will be coming and will be asking you verbally the questions, so that there is a discipline, because we are known for the personal attention. So this is the feature which is very, very important for you, that we will be asking you verbal questions. So before that, you have to anyway complete the monthly compilation. So we have to ensure that there is systematic and disciplined study. That is the important part. Then every month we will also be giving 40 to 50 pages current affair. We will be giving the complete compilation, which will be maybe 200 pages in a month. And we will be giving a short synopsis of 40 pages. so that for the final revision you can use that, and we will also be giving yearly compilation. And these lectures will be the wonderful thing, because you will get to know everything. There are a lot of doubts, lot of issues which you face whenever you are reading the current affairs. So all those doubts can be cleared by the expert faculties. Okay, so the details of this program have been given on the website. Let me show you. So are you interested to know more about that? By the way, if you are part of the prelims ka mains program, then this is already included. So many of you are already part of the prelims ka mains program. So then this is already part of the course. The cost of this program is 8,260 rupees, and if you enroll by tomorrow, you get a 20% discount. So 20% discount you will be getting if you enroll by tomorrow. And you can see this important aspect: live interactive sessions, subject wise coverage. So our coverage will be subject wise. The expert will come and discuss. For example, I will be teaching the economy. Science and technology will be covered by Girish sir, and like that. 20 MCQ based prelims test. So 2000 MCQ you will be solving during the next 9 months. Classes will be on weekend only. You will be getting the study material, subject wise also, monthly also, daily also. And we will tell you how to read, how to cover that. And we will be taking your verbal test so that we can check your preparedness. We will be maintaining one Excel sheet for every student, and we will be taking a personal track so that you don't miss out on the timeline, because timeline is very, very important. All of you know how to cover the current affair, but in our day-to-day life, we actually miss out the important part. Then we will be giving the daily prescription, doubt clearing sessions will be happening. 10 MCQ we will practice at the end of every class also. Okay, we will cover economic survey, budget, everything. And you can see this test will be happening. The focus will be on the perspective building, not just telling you the facts which you already know. Okay, we will cover all the possible sources which I discussed already. And this will be taken by the complete team of faculty. Okay, so if you have any query, you can drop an email at contact@dadami. And a special offer for the participants of this webinar: if you join by tomorrow, you get 20% discount. If you are part of the prelims cum mains program, then you don't need to follow, don't need to buy this program, because that is already covered in your syllabus, in your program. Okay, now apart from this, we also having a complete prelims cum mains program, which is covering the complete prelims syllabus, complete main syllabus. Online program, this is completely online program. Prelims, mains, interview, basic concept, starting from the NCERT to the basic sources to the exam orientation. We will be discussing everything, and there will be weekly test. The test will start from the NCERT. After that, we will test based upon the standard textbook, and simultaneously current affair will also be going on. Then we will also give you a specific previous year question based test. At the end, we will give you mock test and the CSAT based test also, right? Every area will be covered. Current affair booster is already part of this program. Subject wise notes you will be getting, toppers sessions will be there, and special doubt clearing sessions will be happening on every Saturday. Okay, so for this program we have already conducted scholarship test. Those people who are eligible for scholarship, we have sent the email to them. So discount from 10% onwards is available. Next test is happening on 4th of October. If you did not appear the scholarship test so far, then you can appear. If you have already appeared, then don't appear. Next webinar is also happening on 4th of October. If you are new in this session, if you want to know more about how to prepare for the IAS examination, complete strategy, then you should come on 4th October 1 PM, that is Sunday 1 PM. So on Sunday 1 PM, we will discuss the complete strategy, and on Sunday 4 PM, there will be scholarship test again. So based upon that scholarship test, you can get a discount up to 20% amount. Okay, on the complete program and on the other individual programs also. So if you buy other programs also, then you get a discount. So these are all features: live classes, doubt clearing sessions, PDF notes, weekly test, and we have a best pool of faculty. And we are known for two things: personal attention and quality exam orientation. We will make it sure that you get the best, because our batch size is very, very selected. And we have a one-to-one interaction with the faculty, which is hardly available in today's time. Okay, now एक्स्ट्रा एडवांटेजेस, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दीज बैचेस आर वीकेंड फोकस्ड, सो सैटरडे संडे आर हाईली इंटेंसिव, सो दैट यू कैन यूटिलाइज योर टाइम इन द बेस्ट पॉसिबल मैनर. डाउट क्लियरिंग सेशंस एवरी सैटरडे, देन पर्सनल ट्रैकिंग बेस्ड अपॉन गूगल एक्सेल शीट. सो वी विल बी हैविंग वन गूगल एक्सेल शीट फॉर एवरी स्टूडेंट एंड यू विल बी रिक्वायर्ड टू अपडेट दैट शीट ऑन अ डेली बेसिस सो दैट वी कैन ट्रैक व्हाट इज योर प्रोग्रेस. So you cannot be complacent. If you join this batch, only serious people, only those people who want to qualify in the 2021 itself, they are allowed, not other people are allowed. Okay? And this batch will be completely exam oriented. No wastage of time, right? All the sources of current affair, everything will be covered here. All the static portion, weekly test will be based upon NCERT, previous year question, subject wise test, current affair test, CSAT test, right? Many of you are already part of this program. So congratulations for you. This is also a very unique aspect of us. Exam time synopsis, revision tools, where we are providing the clip of 5 minutes and unlimited number of views of the recording so that you can revise as per your convenience whenever you feel that you want to revise any topic. This is a schedule on a weekly basis. If you follow, in the morning we will be taking prelims classes, in the evening we will be taking GS mains classes. Because for the next year, if you are preparing for the 2021, then you don't have the time between prelims and mains. So best thing will be that you prepare next 3 months for the mains also, along with the prelims. So next 3 months, we will be focusing on the mains also. So in the morning, you have prelims class, in the evening, you have mains class. Okay. So that next 3 months are going to be the wonderful month of your wonderful time of your preparation. And you don't feel burdened after that. Right. And we want to ensure that you qualify the IAS exam. You just don't qualify the prelims examination. Many people, they say that, sir, I want to first prepare for the prelims. I always say, are you aiming for clearing the prelims examination or are you aiming to clear the IAS examination? So you must know that you have to prepare simultaneously. You cannot segregate the preparation of prelims and mains. And that is what we do. We also do. Right. So this is a group of faculties and many more faculties are there. And yeah, so the link is available. These are students reviews and in the past we have very good results also. Scholarship test is happening on the 4th of October. You can get this scholarship test. Queries, if you have, you can get resolved on this number. Right. Now I will be taking your session. I will be taking your queries. And before I take the queries, let me tell you again that we are having a series of webinar. This series of webinar, you can see, we already completed economy. Today is current affair. Next will be how to prepare the GS mains on 6th of October. Answer writing, 8th of October. Essay, 12th of October. IR, 15th of October. NCERT, 19th of October. Prelims MCQ, 25th of October. And other experts will also be coming. They will also be sharing their strategy. Okay. These are the free resources which are available on our website. Daily initiatives, free downloads, prelims MCQ, news prescription, mains articles, optional strategy, all these are available on our website. Yojana download, Kurukshetra, all NIOS books, UPSC previous year questions. Beginners ke liye bahut achhi achhi cheeze hain. Syllabus, FAQs and basic things. How to prepare the timetable, self-study and roadmap to success, list of books, everything, like all the things are available. You should also subscribe to the YouTube channel. I will give the link of YouTube channel. And then we have a very wonderful Telegram channel which is growing very, very fast, and because of your love and support only. And we are sharing a lot of daily updates, right? So you will get all the updates. And we have free download section on the website where we are uploading regularly current affairs and other resources. You can use that also.